is really happening. Right now I'm in Beijing, China. I just landed from Stockholm and I'm gonna pick up my luggage and head down to Kunming to tell you guys more about what's going on in China. Not only China is happening, but my first YouTube channel and video. So just picked up the luggage. It took me 40 minutes because this was so much thing I had to do first, like with the visa and stuff. So, and I also took a train, but yeah, I'm gonna find the next flight to Kunming, and we'll be 4 hours flight, I think. Finally in Kunming after 14 hours flight in 24 hours. So yeah, the boys will pick me up in the airport soon, and we will go to the house, and I will tell you guys more about why I'm there. Guys, finally here, Huansheng Lake, 1 hour from Kunming. As you probably see, I have been there for 1 week, and the plan was to film and talk about why I'm here the day I arrived. But the day I arrived, it was so much happening. Like, we get bikes, we travel, race weekend, sponsor meetings. Like, everything happened so fast. So yeah, I will tell you more about it now, why I'm here, and yeah. Long story long, this October last year, when I was in Sierra Nevada, I suddenly got a message from a guy called Jordi that we will meet later. Random message on Instagram, like he wanted me to join him to go continental rider in China. And I was like, yeah, I want that. It took me like 10 minutes, I think. And yeah, I signed a contract, and suddenly I'm in China. That's crazy. So far away from Norway. And as I told you, I have been there for 1 week. And the experience so far is, yeah, it's so much new culture, food, and the people here are really different. But the reason why I did it, because I was not a continental rider before, and I wanted to challenge myself and take the next step. I don't know what I expect, but we will ride some good races, a lot of races, and the place here is in altitude, so I will be here for 3 months and go back home, then come back for 3 months again. So I think this year will be probably take 2 steps by myself and develop as a rider. And I don't know what happened next year, but I took the challenge to like get out of the comfort zone. I don't see much European guys there except me and Jordi almost. So I think this will be a nice challenge for us. Not as a rider, but also as a person in the normal world. But so yeah, that's why I'm here, to challenge myself and take a step or two, and of course see crazy things, meet crazy people. So yeah, that's it, and I will show you the team house we live in, and you will probably see one of the guys. Yeah. Yeah, this is the team house. Altitude 1800, temperature every day 20 to 30 degrees. So yeah, it's around 15 riders or so in the house. The Belarus national team is also here, so we will have a lot of training and intervals with them. The house is 15 riders, as I said, and probably 5 or 6 like normal people, chef and DS and mechanics. So I will show you inside now. Living room, bikes, TV, couch, Belarus, professional rider. Well, we are all really sunburned. Just watch him.
Gone.
Yeah.
You made this painting yesterday?
I actually did. Yesterday I couldn't sleep, so I just... It's around 6 floors. Mi casa, su casa. Pretty big. Two guys here. Me here, Jordi here. And we're gonna live here for 3 months or so. So it's pretty organized. We buy oats, a lot of oats, water, protein shakes, because here in China they don't eat oats at all and almost no protein. So breakfast in the team house is like noodles and yeah, crazy. So we buy this legit protein shake. We have gels
from Taiwan.
So yeah,
which actually is quite good.
It is, yeah.
45 carb.
Works, yeah. And I think it will be a good 3 months with training in altitude, eating good, travel, competitions. It's like I said, the first week here was like so much, so I will just show through the weekend, like last weekend, when we got the bikes and traveling, race day, team sponsors and everything. So yeah.
Hello.
Who are you?
My name is Jordi Slotius. I'm from Poland, but I live in Spain since 2001.
Yeah. What's the plan this weekend?
So Saturday we have like a criterium from 80 kilometers. And I think we have to win.
Yeah,
you
have to win. And how long is the travel, like in the car?
800 kilometers.
Oh.
Which we do now.
Yeah.
And it's 12 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
So we arrive and we sleep.
Yeah.
And tomorrow we will do recon.
Yeah, nice. So I'm gonna have some lunch. Now
your love is fake.
Yeah.
I feel it fade. Your love is fake. I feel it fade. Your love is fake. Woman, I feel it fade.
Just arrived after a 10-hour road trip to Chengdu, and we will spend the weekend here. I live with a guy called Puk, and he's out eating, and I didn't want to risk anything, like eat on the street food. So, and the hotel dinner is closed because it's 11 at the night here. So I bought this for dinner and a Snickers, but that's gone. But yeah, it will be better with the dinner tomorrow, and we will do a recon of the race on Saturday. And it's a pretty small city, just 22 million people here. So, but where is the people? The noodles was pretty silly. But it's okay, I think I'm gonna eat two buckets of this before I go to sleep. We have a breakfast 8 in the morning before we go through the course, like I said. And I will try to make some video through the weekend. And post the video by day 10 maybe. So yeah, I think the weekend will be good. Done. We are going to train the recon for tomorrow. And who are you?
Yeah, good. Are you ready?
Yeah. Can you talk about who you are? Where are you from?
I'm from Macau.
What's your name?
And I'm 20. My name is. You can call me just call me Pok.
Pok. Yeah.
Yeah.
And what's your specialties, like climbing or?
Yeah, I more prefer climbing.
Yeah, time trial?
What?
You are time trial?
Yeah, I love time trial.
Yeah, nice. So the breakfast was pretty good this morning. Had some porridge and eggs. And yeah, ready to train. Bikes looks ready for a race tomorrow. Got some new Garmin Rally. So much power tomorrow. Power to the metal?
Yes. Dual sided.
Yeah. Course for tomorrow. Pretty many people here. We will do 2.5 hours today with some efforts to, yeah, I need to test the bike a little bit because it's too small actually, so I will get a new bike next week, so I will just use the large bike here. It's actually medium in Norway, so yeah. With 4 minutes LT1 and 2 minutes threshold and some sprint, and yeah, legs feel tired almost because of the traveling, but yeah, it will be pretty good tomorrow, I think. Back from training and eating lunch with the team. It was pretty good course, 7.8 kilometers, just flat out. And the lunch was so much for me. Like, we had 4 or 5 plates with rice and pasta, and a club sandwich, and eggs, and yeah, it was a lot. And that's good because last week I haven't eaten so much, I think, because of the new culture for me. The food is not like Europe. I will show you guys later, but yeah, it was pretty good lunch, and the legs is better now after 40 hours with traveling. And something nice happened because I got a nice message from the boss. He got a new bike for me tomorrow. It's an XL bike, so it's fit me more, so I will test it later today maybe. Something funny came up. This bastard right here is from Norway, and I bought 3 of these for 3 months, so it's 1 in a month. But on day 3 this was almost empty, but that's good, probably just to get demotivated.
So the next plate will be in 1 month. And yeah, sorry for the microphone through the day. It's not so good to film with my phone. It's a low budget video. So you have to live with it. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow through the race day and try to make some filming after it.
On the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Lord and master shall bring disaster to evil factors. Demonic chapters shall be captured by kings through the storms of days after, and to the earth from the sun through triple darkness to blaster with a force that can't be.
Back from the race, and I will give you a short recap. I need to have some cool down and a protein shake or something. I'm hungry as hell.
Just got home from my first race as a continental rider in China. It was as expected, like almost a Belgium kermes, like full gas from the start. And yeah, this was a very good day for us. We had a lot of attacks and we was in everything. So the team is really strong. I was in a breakaway, and I think everybody was in a small breakaway some point of the race. But the Belarus guy and Luis from Colombia, they went with, 2 rounds ago, like 20k or something, with a small group. So mine and the guys on the peloton just wanted to like slow down the speed. So I think we got a lot of haters the first day, so that's probably good, I think. And yeah, I'm really happy with the new bike also. It felt pretty good in the corners, and I had control the whole way, but I think this will be good. It was not so important race today, so it's just almost a short race, like in Belgium, Kermes. So it's good to start and test the legs and feel everything. So it was good. So now I will eat lunch, hopefully. And then I don't know what the plan is, actually. So we will see. Some guys say we should drive 10 hours or we maybe go flight to another city to take sponsor meeting. Who knows? It's China. Everything happened here. So talk to you guys later.
Back from lunch. Just had a big bowl with noodles and eggs. We are packing the car.
Hawk and Jordi, what the plan is?
I don't know.
We don't know.
GG.
The plan.
The plan for the day.
No. Luis, todo bien?
What is the plan?
Champion.
So the plan is to drive to the team house and yeah, 10-hour drive again. The night will be 46 hours traveling this week. Pretty tired, but yeah, it will be a good drive. I will drive soon, just gonna have a meal, lunch number two. And I'm gonna show you guys what this is.
This will be the lunch today. Bien, bien.
Joking. I found a burger, chicken burger, pollo. Nice.
I hope this is not salmonella. We will see.
Good morning.
morning. Just woke up and eating breakfast at the team house in altitude. We came home like 3 in the night yesterday. Pretty tired actually. I woke up 9, so 6 hours is okay, but couldn't sleep anymore. So I find the perfect breakfast: porridge, 4 eggs, and a coffee. And today we will probably do a short spin. And yeah, that's it, I think. Talk to you later. Ready for training. Of course, some rice.
Plata o plomo.
Training finish, 2.5 hours with some LT1, of course, just testing the legs. The altitude is not so remarkable the first days, but we will see. We're gonna eat some lunch and then me and Jordi are gonna head out to the airport actually. So no rest for the European guys, huh? We go to photo shoot, I think.
Yeah, bags packed for the weekend.
Oh, I'm so tired. But now we have to go to Shenzhen. So
yeah. Photoshoot and meetings.
For this helmet.
Yeah. What's the brand?
Sunrimun.
Sunrimun. And they...
the first time that I heard it, I thought it was Shenzhen.
Shenzhen.
But
yeah.
Then it's Sunrimun.
Yeah, they will have some announcement or something.
Yeah.
So they send the European guys to the meeting, and yeah.
If we are better looking.
Of course.
Than the average here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but yeah, it will be. We can just skip through it. Some videos, maybe.
Out running 30 minutes before the gym. We are in with which town is this?
Shenzhen,
close to Hong Kong. Yeah,
yes.
We came to the hotel like 2 in the night, so today will be sponsor and meetings. And yeah, it's a crazy big city, and we are going to the gym now, as I said, pre-breakfast run in Shenzhen. And yeah, I will just skip forward to it through the weekend. Home from the weekend in Shenzhen. I think this is the end of the video. Week, well, first week in China, 6 days and around 80 hours with traveling. So we will sleep now, and tomorrow we go 5 hours in the mountains.
get started with the training, and we have a race in 10 days or something like that. So yeah, I hope the video was good, first video, and I have to say sorry again for low quality sometimes. And yeah, I think it will be a good 10 days train now before a race. So yeah, it was a good weekend, sponsor meeting, as you see. Thanks for watching.